Welcome to the 3SN Road to the Final Four podcast series, where we break down every conference tournament leading up to the big dance and see who makes the bids and whose bubble gets burst. Today we want to look at a couple of conferences that have been overlooked, just because of the tournaments being when they were. First off, we need to apologize for the Sun Belt Conference that just before we knew it, the conference was over, the conference tournament was done, and realized our podcast didn't get up there. So I didn't want to go without having talked a little bit about the great team that Western Kentucky has been since the firing of their head coach in the early parts of the year. Honestly, they had lost at one point, let's see, 8 out of their 7 games, 9 out of 11 games. They had a really tough stretch in the middle of the season, talking December through January. But then, down the stretch, they really improved, and since February 23rd, and that's their last regular season game, or last two games into the conference tournament, they won 6 straight. They knew how to win games down the stretch, and they did it with great fashion all the way through the tournament. They won their games by 4 points, 5 points, 4 points, and 4 points again. They know how to win in a close game, and that's what might make them, even with that record of 15-18, they could be a tough team to beat. They certainly won't be a pushover in a 1-16 seed. There's no doubt that with that losing record, the Hilltoppers will be a team in one of the first four games. And honestly, I feel badly for the number one seed that is going to have to play them, just because, you know, I can see the Hilltoppers being a very good team because they are playing well right now, and that's something that can never be overlooked. So that is for the Sun Belt and the Hilltoppers. Now also, we want to look at the Ivy League, which does not have a conference tournament, but we have now seen there is not going to be any need for a one-game playoff between Harvard and Pennsylvania, as Pennsylvania lost in their season finale. So Harvard gets the regular season championship, and by way of that, they got the automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. Now, Harvard is always a tough team, or any Ivy League team for that matter, is a tough team to watch when they make it to the tournament. This is Harvard's first trip there in over 60 years, excuse me. So what can we expect from the Harvard Crimson? Well, all I can say is that they are a very slow-it-down type offense, and that's to be expected in a league of what the Ivy League is like. They keep it slow, they play smart, and really they force a lot of errors from their opponents because they just wear you down because of how smart they do play. Top scorer averaging only 11 points per game, that's Kyle Casey, but all the way down you got consistent scorers, everybody plays so they're always fresh, and that's going to be something tough for a team to be able to take down. Harvard, I'm going to expect to be about an 11 seed, possibly a 10 seed, I guess, maybe. But for me, what's really cool about Harvard is the fact that even with their terrible schedule, strength of schedule, RPI, they're 26-4. They know how to win. I'm not sure if they'll win in the tournament or not, but they are a team to definitely keep your eye on as a result. And finally, the last team we want to look at is the Great West Conference. The Great West does not have an automatic bid into the NCAA tournament, but that doesn't mean that it's not something that we want to be keeping our eyes on. So in the Great West, the teams that are really going to, or that are supposed to be the top one, would be Utah Valley. And sadly, Utah Valley last night decided to lose to NJIT, New Jersey Institute of Technology, a team that is below 500 on the year. They lost to them by 10 in overtime. So that leaves NJIT to be playing either North Dakota or UTPA, that is Texas Pan American, in the championship. So North Dakota is probably going to take it all at this point, and that's a little bit of a shocker to me, but in this one it's interesting scenario because the winner does not get any automatic bid. None of these teams will make the tournament, but still it is championship week and they deserve to be discussed. So watch for Utah Valley now to take the run to the Great West title game. Well, that's it for breaking down the Sun Belt, the Ivy, and the Great West. For all of your conference tournaments updates, you can follow us on Twitter at 3S Network and 360sportsnetwork.com for all the Road to the Final Four glory and all the updates that you will need to make your bracket as best as you can. For ESN, I'm James Dodson. Have a good one.